unease over doing business with China extending to the Baltic states. Lithuania's foreign minister says 2 years after a major run-in, companies in his nation are still concerned about trading with Beijing. In 2021, Lithuania allowed Taiwan to open a de facto embassy on its soil, called a Taiwanese representative office. The Chinese communist regime lashed out over the opening, dumping a trade ban on Lithuania and recalling its ambassador. Beijing claims Taiwan as part of mainland Chinese territory and strongly rebukes any official engagement between the island and foreign countries. The regime has never ruled Taiwan. Trade relations quickly crumbled after the ban. Chinese imports plunged 99.8% in early 2022, spurring the European Union to file a complaint with the World Trade Organization against China. The case has not been resolved. Lithuania's foreign minister has noted that Beijing removed most of its trade restrictions, but called it a huge trust issue on Monday. Quote, "Nobody can be sure that it cannot be repeated because it's a non-rules-based approach." China still defends its response as legitimate. Beijing continues flexing military might over Taiwan, sending aircraft across the unofficial divide between Taiwan and China on Thursday in a rare nighttime flight. Taiwan is preparing for a presidential and parliamentary elections in January. Next, more top news from Asia Pacific. We start with a high-stakes meeting in China. As the EU-China summit kicks off in Beijing on Thursday, one leader might be making a quick exit. European Council President Charles Michel will reportedly head home after the first day of meetings. Why? According to a European Union official, the president lacks a secure phone line in Beijing to talk with EU leaders without China listening in.